If a man can say of his life, or any moment of his life, there is nothing more to be desired. His state becomes like that told in the famous double sonnet, but without the sonnet's restrictions. Let him go look at the river flowing, or the bank of late flowers. There will be one small fly still among the petals, in those gauzy wings raised above its back. A rainbow shines. The world to him is radiant, and even the fact of poverty is holy without despair. So it seems until they're roused to him pictures of the systematically starved for a purpose. At the mind's proposal, what good then? The light-winged fly, the flower, or the river, too foul to drink of, or even to bathe in. The 90-story building beyond the ocean that a rocket will span for destruction in a matter of minutes, but will not bring him, in a century, food or relief of any sort from his suffering. A healthy skin, a wrath that is never revealed till we are about to eat, and it revolts us. Beauty, beauty should make us paupers, should blind us, rob us. For it does not feed the sufferer, but makes his suffering a fly-blown putrescence, and ourselves decay. Unless the ecstasy be general, the world to him is radiant, and even the fact of poverty is holy without despair.